Good morning, students. In today's class of retail management, we'll start with a new topic, that is non-store retailing. In the previous classes, we have studied what are the various formats of retailing. Now, we will be focusing on non-store retailing. Let us recap what we have read in the previous classes. In the previous classes, we have studied that the retail formats are of three types: store-based, non-store-based, service-based. We have completed the store-based retail formats. Under the store-based retail formats, we have completed both the ownership-based retail formats and merchandise-based retail formats. Under the ownership-based retail formats, independent retailers, chain retailers, franchises, cooperative stores, these are the ownership-based retail formats. Then coming to the merchandise-based retail formats, they are like convenience stores, supermarkets, hypermarkets, specialty stores, department stores, factory outlets, catalog showrooms. So we have discussed about the various retail formats that are store based. That means in order to continue or have this kind of retail format, you need to have a store in place. Now coming to another format of retail, that is non-store based retail format. Under the non-store based retail format or non-store based retailing, there is no need to have a physical store in order to do the retail business. Under this non-store based retailing, we'll be studying direct sales, email orders, postal orders, telemarketing, automated vending, etc. Now we'll start with the non-store based retailing. Now when we say non-store based retailing, these are the various types of non-store based retailing which we will include in our study. That is direct selling, telemarketing, direct marketing, automated vending, electronic retailing, and information kiosk. So these are the things we'll be exploring in the present class under the non-store based retailing. Now we'll start with the first format, that is direct selling. You have to remember that in non-store retailing, the customer do not need to go to the store to buy the products. This type of retailing is nowadays becoming very, very much vital. And this non-store retailing, in the absence of the shop and selling on the without any shop, is great for the customers because they can directly get the products into their home. In India, around 20% of present retail is done through this non-store based retailing. The major types of non-store retailing, as we have studied the headings, now we'll discuss one by one. The first one is direct sales or direct selling. When we say direct selling, it means it is defined as a personal contact between a salesperson and a consumer away from a retail shop. So here there is a personal contact with the salesperson and the consumer, but this contact is away from the retail store. Then it is known as direct selling. Now coming to what is direct selling, sales occur at home. So if not at the retail store, then where does the sale occur? The sale occurs at home, workplace, or other non-store location. So in direct selling, there is no need to have a physical store. So this is included in the non-store retailing. It eliminates the several of the middlemen involved in the production distribution. In the product distribution, all the middlemen that are involved, those are removed in the direct selling, such as direct, this regional distribution center, dealer, wholesaler, and finally to the customer, retailer, and then to the customer. So all these middlemen are removed. What happens in direct selling? Here, instead, the products go from manufacturer to the direct sales company, and from the direct sales company to a distributor or representative, and from there it will directly go to the consumer. So the middleman is reduced. So this is suited for products that require extensive demonstration. That means the certain products that require certain demonstration, because due to the complexity of the product. So this is suitable for those products which require a little bit of extensive demonstration, so that the person will be at ease in his home, work or non-store location. He can give more time to understand the complete demonstration and then be interested to buy the product. So this comes under direct selling. When we say direct selling, there are also means is one of the olden forms of non-retail, non-store retailing. It involves retailing of goods and services directly to the consumers, and this may be as discussed in the workplace or home or any other location. There is no fixed retail location, so there is no need to have a retail location site. In direct selling, there is a direct contact of the retailer with the consumers or the final consumers. It is highly interactive form of retailing. Mostly jewelry, cosmetics kind of products are generally sold through direct retailing. However, we have to understand there are various kinds of direct retailing or direct selling. We'll understand one by one. The first one, direct selling type, is single level direct sales or one-to-one selling. This is also known as one-to-one selling. So what happens under this? This type of sales is done one-to-one, such as through door-to-door or doing in-person presentations. So here it is a single level direct sales, where one person goes from door-to-door and meets these customers, or directly from one person to another person gives the presentation about the products. Usually by prior arrangement or introduction, an explanation or a demonstration is given by the direct seller to a customer and the customer's family. So what happens in single level direct sales, in direct selling, there is a certain kind of prior arrangement or introduction involved, where an explanation or demonstration is given to the customer and the customer's family. So this is what happens under direct level, single level direct sales or one-to-one selling. A person visits the customer and tries to sell the product to the potential user. Especially if you say an example, Tupperware was one of the products which was pioneered in this type of sales approach. Tupperware products are demonstrated and then sold. So Tupperware is a product which was sold generally by the single level direct sales. Now coming to the second type of direct selling method is party plan direct sales, or this is known as party plan or one to many. Here one person tries to sell the product to many customers. Let me explain that. Selling through explanation and demonstration of products to a group of prospective customers by a direct seller. So what happens in this? The same thing is happening just like the direct level, single level direct sales, where there was an explanation or demonstration was given by the direct seller to the customer and the customer's family. Here the only difference is that this explanation and demonstration of the product is done by the direct seller to a group of prospective customers, by a group of prospective customers or potential customers. Another thing is that usually in the home of a hostess who has invited friends and neighbors to the party. So how do we gather so many people for this presentation or explanation or demonstration? We usually, the direct seller becomes the hostess and invites people, neighbors and friends, telling them that there is a party. So once they come and gather for a party, they will explain about the product. So a salesperson goes to home of a host or himself becomes the host and invites neighbors to the party. The salesperson then demonstrates the product and then takes order. Top performing salespeople often are highly regarded for this kind of party plan direct sales. So this requires a lot of selling technique, and the person has to explain and demonstrate the products to a group of customers and also clear all their doubts. So this requires a little bit of proper idea about the sales technique. Okay, so this is another way of direct selling. Apart from this, there is another method for this direct selling, that is multi-level marketing. This is also known as MLM. What happens in multi-level marketing? Many direct selling companies, both person to person and party plan, are now organized through the multi-level principles. Both the single level one-to-one or multi or party plan type of direct selling are now done through this multi-level principles. What happens? This is where direct sellers are given the opportunity, in addition to the rewards, from making personal sales and to build their own sales team. Here what happens, one person says that not only he becomes, he creates his own sales team, but also gets rewards for making this personal sales. So this is one of the prominent criteria, one of the prominent characteristics of the MLM or multi-level marketing. In doing so, they are able to receive additional rewards that come from the sales achieved by those they have recruited, trained, helped, and motivated. When they create their own sales team, and their own sales team further recruits or further adds members to the chain, then it will create a network, and this will bring additional reward to the direct seller. So what happens? This was mainly pioneered by Amway in 1994. One of the famous companies following this MLM is Amway, a variant of direct selling in which companies recruit independent business people who act as distributor for the product. They act as the distributor for the product. They make personal sales. These in turn, this individual business people or direct sellers that are appointed, they in turn recruit and sell to sub-distributors. These people sell to the sub-distributor who eventually recruit others to sell their products. So in this way, a tiered system, a network system is formed in which sellers profit directly if the people under them continue the network. This is done mostly by sponsoring, and the each and every level of people get commission when lower level of network people, they make more and more sales. A best example is Amway. This was pioneered by Amway in 1994. Apart from Amway, there are other companies like Modicare who follow this multi-level marketing. So this is direct selling, and understood what is direct selling and what are the various types of direct selling that happens in non-store retailing. Examples are Amway and Modicare. Now we'll move to another topic, that is telemarketing. Telemarketing means what? Telemarketing means sales made by using telephone. I'll explain you. Telemarketing is defined as contacting, qualifying, and canvassing prospective customers using telecommunication devices such as telephone, fax, and internet. So what we do? We do three things here. We try to contact and qualify and canvass these prospective customers by using of telecommunication devices such as telephone, fax, and internet. So this is known as telemarketing. Telemarketing is also known as telesales or inside sales. Telemarketing may either be carried out by telemarketers or increasingly by automated telephone calls or robocalls. So they may appoint people, telemarketers, who will make these calls, or sometimes they also have this automated telephone calls. This is also known as robocalls. The cost of selling through telephone has reduced drastically over the recent years due to the introduction of computers. The introduction of computers and technology has reduced drastically the level of the cost of selling through this telephone medium. This method of selling is sometimes criticized for violating the consumer's right to privacy. However, this method of telemarketing is criticized because of this violating of the consumer's right to privacy, because these telemarketers continuously make calls and irritate the prospective customers. So this hampers the right to privacy of the customers. So what happens in telemarketing may either be carried out by telemarketer or by automated machines, that may be robot sales. In this, there is contacting, qualifying, and canvassing of prospective customers. This is also known as telesales or inside sales. And one, this is also called as telephone selling because the sale is done over a telephone. And in telemarketing, a salesperson initiates a sale over a phone and to a prospect or a potential customer and then closes it over the phone only. So he tries to explain the product ever on the phone and tries to close the sale or close the deal on the phone only. It consists of cold canvassing from a phone directory. It may also include cold canvassing from or making cold calls from a phone directory. These are various products such as magazine subscriptions like pest control, club membership, credit card. These are generally done through this telemarketing, which can be sold without seeing or usually sold directly to the customers. However, it is important that this method of selling is sometimes criticized. Why they are criticized? Because the intrusive or the interfering nature of the telemarketing people. They continuously call people and sometimes they involve in scams, these fraudulent transactions over telephone. So this has created a lot of backlash and bad name for telemarketing in recent times. However, with the increase of this computer by making robocalls and use of technology, the cost of making sales through telemarketing has reduced very, very greatly. So this is another method of non-store retailing, that is telemarketing. After telemarketing, we'll understand another type of non-store retailing, that is direct marketing. So we'll understand what happens in direct marketing. Direct marketing is a way of contacting customers through broadcasting or print media, who in turn buy products without visiting a retail store. So here also the no store is required, and in direct marketing is a way of contacting these customers through broadcasting or print media. We use broadcasting or print media in order to sell the products without visiting this store. Direct marketing removes the middleman from the promotion process, as the company's message is provided directly to the potential customer. So what happens in direct marketing? There are no middlemen, and the promotion process, what the company wants to sell, the product, the features, the offer, everything is directly provided to the potential customer. Direct marketing uses various advertising media to interact directly with the customers. They use a lot of advertising media, different medias, in order like radio or television, newspaper or magazines. We can also say catalogs or directly mailing to the customers. So they use a lot of media in order to reach the customers directly and advertise their products. Direct marketing provides many benefits to the customers, consumers. What happens, this direct market is important because it provides a lot of benefits to the consumers, like shopping outcome becomes more convenient, the shopping experience becomes more convenient, it becomes more hassle-free because you need not go in order to a retail shop to buy the product. It saves a lot of time. Also, it introduces a new lifestyle and facilitates a larger section of merchandise. It is a new lifestyle because this was not previously present. So this is a non-traditional format. This non-store retailing is a non-traditional retailing format where stores are not required. So it's a new lifestyle. People can sit in their homes and can order things directly. And it facilitates a larger selection of merchandise because the people have more time to select the merchandise, compare the merchandise, and then make a decision. Okay, so this is very important to understand. What happens? The direct marketers may use media, radio, TV, magazines, newspapers, or catalogs or direct mail in order to induce people to buy the products. direct marketers may be classified as general merchandise firms or specialty merchandise, and both of them things are generally sold. Direct marketing provides many benefits, as we have said that it provides this convenience, saves time, it is hassle-free, and creates a lifestyle for the persons involved. So this is the way direct marketing impacts the customers, and they easily in a convenient manner can make their purchases. That is the reason direct marketing as a non-store retail format is getting a lot of importance. Now we will understand what are the various types of direct marketing that are available for sales. First is direct mail marketing. Here a mail is directly sent from the seller to the buyer or the consumer. What happens? Let us understand. Direct mail marketing is the buying of goods or services by mail delivery. So there is buying and selling of goods and services by using this mail delivery. Products are delivered directly to an address supplied by the customer. What happens? They will mail you the description about the products. Once you have decided you want to buy, you will mail them that you want those products, and they will deliver the product directly at your doorstep of the customer. Forms, mail letters, what they do generally, they mail letters, brochures about the products, and even product samples is sent to these customers, asking them to make a purchase by telephone or mail. So generally mails are waste, then brochures are sent, and these products, sometimes product samples are also sent, so that customers will understand the quality about the product, will understand what the product is, what are the features, what are the offers associated with the product, and then can make a purchase over telephone. So the mail may contain information regarding the offers, regarding announcement, reminders, regarding the, if this, it is a brochure, you have to reminding about the various features and facilities the product has. This kind of marketing is popular because it provides flexibility and can be personalized. So this mail, direct mail marketing can be personalized as per the needs of the consumer. So this is one of the reasons, flexibility and this making tailor-made applications helps in direct mail marketing. Now the second type of marketing that is used in direct marketing is catalog marketing. What happens in catalog marketing? Catalog marketing is a form of direct marketing which uses printed catalogs or e-catalogs to display all products and services provided by the company. So they may send two things. Either they may send a printed form of catalogs where from which the consumer can select the product, or they may send a electronic catalog or e-catalog to display all the products and services provided by the company. It is the replacement to the consumer visiting the retail store to check out the relevant product. What happens in catalog marketing? It is a replacement to the consumer, because the consumer now need not go to the retail store to make relevant purchases. So this is a replacement. So what happens? It is in which catalog marketing, companies mail catalogs to consumers and make them available at the retail stores. And it is very, very essential because it helps the consumers to buy directly from the provider. This is one of the reasons why people follow or interested in catalog marketing, because they directly are able to buy the products from the provider, and it is a replacement of the customer visiting the retail store to check the relevant products. So this is also the reason why people are interested in catalog marketing. So we have understood the two types of direct marketing, that is direct mail marketing and catalog marketing. Apart from this, there is another type of direct marketing, that is televised shopping or television shopping. So what is televised shopping? Televised shopping means in which various categories of products are promoted on dedicated TV channels through various infomercials and where people can learn about the features of the product and can place orders over the phone instantly. So what happens, a televised version of the product is shown in the way of infomercial. And what happens in infomercials, where the people mean the customers, are able to understand and learn about the various features of the product, and they are able to understand how they can use the product. The use of the product is properly demonstrated. The evidence, physical evidence is given, telling how the product has improved the lives of the customers who are already using the product. So this entices, this encourages the customers to make a call and book for the products. They can also be short term, which refers to a typical 30 to 60 second commercials, and even long term extended to 30 minutes infomercials. So there are two type of short term and long term these infomercials used. It may be a 30 seconds to 60 second short term kind of infomercial, or it may be a 30 minutes long, more than 30 minutes long infomercial explaining the various features of the product. The TV channels are very important, because this through these TV channels only, these dedicated TV channels, they are able to sell the product to the people. So let me tell you another thing is that this type of TV response marketing through information can be considered as a direct marketing, since responses are in the form of calls to the telephone numbers given on air. Here the response, it is can be also known as TV response marketing, because here the response of the customers are based on the informations given on the TV, and they, once they are attracted with the information, they call and make purchases. Okay, and these TV commercials may be for a short term or for a long time. If we give you an example of these tele brands, Asian Shopping Sky and Time Shopping, these are certain Time Shopping India, certain examples which are using dedicated channels to promote their products to the consumers. And the consumers, after going through the short term and long term infomercial, are able to make a more knowledge decision regarding the purchase of the product. Now, after direct marketing, so these are the various forms of direct marketing that is used. And apart from direct marketing, there are other non-stop based retail formats. Let us understand another of non-stop based retail formats, that is automated vending. What happens in automated vending? Automated vending is also very popularly used, and is this kind of automated vending is increasing day by day in India due to its convenience. Let us understand what is automated vending. The sale of product is done through a machine with no personal contact between buyer and seller, is called automatic vending or automated vending. The sale is done through machine with no personal contact with the buyer and seller. There is no personal contact between the buyer and seller, and the whole process of this buying and selling takes place with the help of a machine. The appeal of automatic vending is convenient purchase. Convenient purchase. This is very important. You are able to buy the product as and when you require. If it is available in a retail store, there are particular timings within which the retail store will be open and you can buy the product. But when it is available in automatic vending, it is available 24/7. And as per your convenience, you can purchase the product. So this is one of the main highlights of automated vending. Vending machines can expand a firm's market by reaching consumers where and when they cannot come to a store. There are various places where the consumers may not be able to come to a store. In those places, we can have these vending machines, which will expand the firm's market share. Automatic vending has high operating cost. Even though a lot of facilities are there, it is convenient to purchase, it will increase the firm's market share, there are high operating costs, because they need to be replenished with inventories frequently, and these machines also require a lot of maintenance and repairs. So this is a costly affair. So that is the reason people are not much interested in automated vending. However, majority of automatic vending sales are for what? For cold drinks, coffee, candy, cigarettes. These are the things for which automated vending is generally done. Most of this automatic vending machines or automated vending is found in schools, workplaces, public facilities, etc. So in these places where it is easier for the people, for the firm to sell to the people. So what happens? The sale of products is done through a machine in automatic vending without any known personal contact between the buyer and the seller. This form of non-store retailing, in which the products are stored in a machine and dispensed to the customer when they deposit money. So there are machine having the product. So once you dispense machine or put currency into the machine, the machine will dispense the product. Vending machines are placed at more convenient places, like nowadays are placed in airports, schools, colleges, hospitals, shopping malls, working areas or working places. These are the places where vending machines are put up. These machines primarily contains products like coffee, cold drink, candy, cigarettes, snacks. All these kind of products are generally sold by these automated machines. These machines, however, even though they provide the convenience of purchase, these are a little bit difficult because they require a lot of maintenance and a continuous replenishment of inventories. This is highly problematic. However, this advancement of technology has made it easy to monitor these vending machines from a distance and also reducing the chances of lack of inventory or out of stock or out of order or theft. These kind of problems, which was previously present in automated vending machines, nowadays they are removed by the use of more technological features. So these thefts, this out of stock and monitoring the automated vending machines from a distance is possible nowadays. So it is one of the growing non-store retail formats in India. Now coming to another kind of retail, non-store retail formatting, that is electronic retailing. What happens in electronic retailing? When a firm uses its website to offer products for sale, and then individuals or organizations use computer to place order for purchasing the product. So here the firm who is selling the product, they use to sell the products through the websites. And the persons, individuals or organizers who want to purchase these products, they place the order for purchasing on the websites. It enables consumers to shop from anywhere using internet and web-based application. So why this is very famous? Because it helps the consumers to shop from anywhere. If the only thing that is required is web-based application and by using internet. Success of e-retailing or electronic retailing requires strong branding. Because if you don't have a strong brand, people will not be interested to buy your product. So it must be so strong branding, and the website must be engaging. It should be easily navigable and regularly updated as per the needs and wants of the consumers. And the product should be competitively priced. So in order to make electronic retailing successful, we require that the brands that are sold through electronic retailing must be strong. Branding should be there. The website should be engaging. It should be easily navigable. And the updated, the web-based applications and the website must be regularly updated as per the changing demands of the customers, and the product should be priced very competitively. E-retailers need strong distribution efficiency, so consumers are not waiting long periods of time for the product or services they want to purchase. So a good distribution system is required so that immediately when the order is placed, within minimum time, the order is fulfilled. Rising internet penetration is expected to lead to the growth in e-commerce. So what has been the reason or the main engine for boosting this electronic retailing is that the internet penetration. Today the internet is available at such cheap rates, so this has made it easier for electronic retailing to succeed in the market. Largest of this online retailing that are present are Alibaba, and then it is Flipkart, Amazon, eBay. So these are the various e-commerce sites which are famous and available for the customers, from which the customers can choose the products and through this website or this web-based applications and buy them. This kind of retailing is gaining importance in recent years, and the rapid diffusion of this internet and technology and usage has resulted in the growth of this electronic retailing in India. Now we'll understand the last kind of non-store retailing that is gaining importance in India, that is information kiosk. What happens in information kiosk? In information kiosk, a kiosk is a small freestanding physical structure that displays information or provides a service. So kiosk is a small freestanding physical structure where the display of information is done, electronic display of information is done, and this kiosk forms the basis for providing a service and information to the end consumers. What happens? This kiosk comprises of computer terminals housed inside a touchscreen on the outside that provides the consumer with the product and company information. So what happens? There is a computer terminal housed inside a touchscreen machine, and on the touchscreen, if the consumer touches, it will get the information regarding the various product and the product information and the company information. So it is helpful for the consumer to understand regarding the product and the company delivering the product. This helps the consumers in making the purchase. It also serves as a market research tool for the retailers. Not only it makes the consumers to get the information, thereby enabling the customer to make a more informed purchase, but it also serves as a market research tool because the retailer now knows what are the various products the people are more interested in. Kiosk can be both manned or unmanned. It can be completely automated or manned, or maybe digital or non-digital. Interactive information kiosk is a more modern, effective way to communicate with your intended audiences. This has become a more modern and interactive and more effective way to communicate with your potential customers, because the potential customer need not go visit any website, need not go and call anybody to in order to get information, need not speak to anybody. They can directly use the information kiosk by using the touch screen. They can get the information about the product, and they can get the information regarding the company information. All this information can be easily got. These are usually placed, this kind of in shopping malls, these are placed, or for promotion for any particular product, or in shopping malls, or in airports, railway stations, even for navigation within the mall, this is also used. Also in libraries. So these are the places where this information kiosks are put up so as to help the final consumers, the intended potential audiences, to get information regarding the product and the company information. So this is also one of the non-store retailing formats that are used. So these are the various non-store retailing formats that we have discussed today. If you have any doubts, no need to panic, contact me. I'll be sending you the notes digitally. Please go through that. If you have any other things to any doubts, just contact me. And finally, thank you for your attention.